In part 1, we built the base components with Bolt, and in part 2, we leveled up with Cursor IDE and Klein for advanced development. In this final part, we'll use Aider for those last fine-tuned edits and then deploy our app. In order to use Aider, I will hide Klein for now, and then I will go to my terminal here and let me zoom in for a bit, and then I will execute Aider. I have Aider installed here, and if you want to know how to install Aider, I have a separate video on how to do that. I will link it again in the video description as well as somewhere up there in this video. So I'll enable prompt caching. Yes, please. I will git commit first. And then let's move on. I will add Aider the spec file, the flow, but instead of adding, I will say read only because we are not going to change this. If we take a look at the content of that file, let me close all of this and open the tutorial flow. It's a diagram. I guess it's better to use this mermaid diagram. So user entry, there's a landing page, tutorial overview, progress resume, tutorial container, lesson selection, jury practice challenge. I will ask Aider to check the layout if it matches the flow. So the layout, take a look at the layout. You can see the progress tracker, the lessons, for example, lessons. Where is it? Lessons is in the navigation bar. Okay, so what I will ask Aider is to check the navigation bar. I will add it so Aider will be able to see the contents of it. But this time I will use slash add because I expect Aider to edit this file, but not this one. Check the navigation bar component and see if it follows the tutorial flow and what's already implemented. Right now we can navigate to the lessons via the, I will mention here the progress tracker. So you see, if I mention the progress tracker here without adding it, Aider will ask me to add it later. Since I didn't explicitly added this component beforehand, before asking Aider anything, now Aider is asking me to add this, so I will say yes. And you can observe how Aider is doing the changes, and it's much faster than Klein and Bolt. So this is the fastest way of editing, and I will show you why. And you can see here the reason. So it's modifying the navigation bar. It's trying to search only the relevant portion of the file and then replacing it with the corrected version until here. If needed, it will do the same for the other files. So right now, it only updated this component. But why we cannot see what's changed? Because Aider automatically commits the changes by default. We can turn this off, but by default, it is turned on. So the only way to see what's changed is if we go to the source control panel here. And as you can see, we have a new commit here. Feature integrate tutorial component. If we click on this and hide the primary sidebar, we can see here that it changed this file, and the difference is all of this. So it's basically doing the same thing as Klein is doing, but it makes our life more easier because it's automatically committing the changes. We can revert back any changes that we don't want to push or to be committed. We can do that here by clicking on it, or here, commit, undo last commit. Or if you have the Git lens, you can go here and click this button, undo commit. But right now, let's check what happened. Aider removed that portion. So the progress tracker is here already, so it doesn't need that. But now the lessons is not wired to anything. Looks like the layout is somewhat not good right now. So we will ask Aider to update the navigation bar. What it did here is it removed the progress button since we have the progress tracker, added a tutorial context integration, make the home logo clickable, really? Oh yeah. And then made the lessons button functional, but it's not working. Added hover effects for better UX. Okay, I didn't notice that. And remove and use academic cap icon. So let's ask Aider to do further changes. Please fix lessons link. Okay, so you see, it only tries to search for this particular part of the code, so not the whole code. It already fixed the issue. And if we go here and click the lessons, it will go back to the first lesson. Looking good. Now, I don't like the layout of the navigation right now. Since we already have the navigation bar in the context, in the chat history, we can still ask for more updates on the navigation bar. And by the way, you can see the cost estimates here. this particular message, the last prompt that I mentioned, it cost me 2 cents. For the entire session, it just cost me 5 cents at this point. Okay, now let's ask Ader to improve UX even further. The logo and the header is not aligned. Ader can also accept image. So before I do this, I will need to add the image. So how can we do that? I will create a screenshot. I will copy this screenshot in my clipboard. I will go back to cursor and then I will say here paste. And then I will name this UI sample. And then I will simply enter. What it will do is it will save the image that is currently in my clipboard to a temporary file. Let's type in our prompt again. See the attached UI. Hopefully it will see the it's not aligned with the design, making more compact. So it did change something here. Reduce the navbar height, darken the background, simplify the button styles, made the layout more consistent. What it did it change? Yeah, there you go. Looking good now. I'm satisfied with this change now. All right. Okay, so now the final thing that I want to implement is this progress indicator. So I will ask Ader again to do that. But this time I will reset everything because the request that I'm going to make is not related anymore to what we've been talking about so far. So I will reset it, effectively removing all the files from the chat history as well as the chat history itself. So I will add the progress tracker and then I will ask Ader to please implement the actual progress tracking right now. Completed icon of the first 3 lessons, if I'm not mistaken, it is set to true. Right now, the complete icon of the first 3 lessons is hard-coded to true. Okay, so let's see what will happen. Okay, so it asks to add the tutorial context. Yes, it searches for the tutorial context and it updates something. By the way, all the actions or changes that Ader is doing is actually maintained in a history file. If you go to the Explorer, you can see there's a chat history. And if you take a look at that, it basically just combine everything we've been talking about here in this chat history file. So if we want to check what's happening or what we did the other day, we can easily review this file. So what changed it did is add the completed section set to track completed sections. So if we take a look at this, it's still set to true. I don't know why. Let me see. Okay, it looks like there's no change here, but we can ask Ader some question. We can use /ask without editing anything. So you see the flexibility of Ader here. If I use this command, Ader will not change any files at all. It will simply answer my question regarding the code base. So I will ask here, when will the progress of a lesson set to complete? What triggers it? There's no actual trigger, okay? We need to add this trigger. Okay, so yes, please. I don't think it changed anything here, but let me ask Ader again. But this time I will ask it, did you update the files? I didn't see any change or commits. Okay, there you go. So now I see a commit. That means we can expect this to be working now. So let's understand when it will be triggered. The progress will be updated when a user completes all sections of a lesson. So how can we do that? Okay, let's ask it again. This is not a question only. This is question plus do what's needed. Yep, the user reaches the last section of this lesson, which appears instead of next. We don't have that. Completes all section, reaches the end. Complete lesson button. There's no complete lesson button as far as I can see. Let me search for it. It's complete next. Where's this used? Lesson container. Let's see the file references. There's no result. It looks like the lesson container is not being used anywhere. I will ask client or Ader, sorry. Let me just search for the next lesson. So I will mention that the one tracking the navigation below is the progress context. Yes. You're right. We should integrate the lesson container functionality. Let me help clean this up, remove the unused, okay? So it's unused, okay? So let's run the shell command and then let's see. Next section. Still not tracking it correctly. Okay. I don't like this UI. So you see Aider is also not perfect. Alright, so now we have some issues here. Let's refresh. So here's what I'm going to do. I will undo commit as well as the other one. I don't like this. And it also doesn't work. And then I will search, where is this? The next section. Okay, so I will mention this tutorial container. Where is it reference? I hope it's referenced somewhere. Well, let's right click, find file references. Yes, it's in the layout. Let me quit Aider again and let's start from the top. Then I will add tutorial container because that's where the next section is. And also I will add the progress tracker. And I will also add the progress bar because it's not being used anywhere. If I'm going to search for it here, let me go to the Explorer and find file references. There's nothing referencing it. Okay, let me close it. So now I'm going to say this wire up the complete section trigger when the next section is clicked. Make sure to update the progress tracker complete icon and also show the progress bar the bottom. Where do we want to place that? Maybe here, the top. It's three requests in one prompt, so let's see if Aider can handle it. There you go, nice. But it didn't wire up the, where did you add the progress bar then? So let me check again. So it's here. But why can't we see it? Okay, let's ask Aider. Alright. But I don't like the format. So let's ask Aider to fix it. Alright. But it didn't change the colors. There you go. So now it's time for us to push this to GitHub and sync all of these changes. So you see Aider committed 12 commits and now we can try to deploy this using Netlify. But before that, let me go to the terminal, close this primary bar and run npm run build. Then let's see if this will succeed. You see there's an issue here. Speed is declared but its value is never read. Okay, so what we can do here is then I will run npm run build and I will add the output to the chat. Yes, please fix the issues so the build will succeed. So it says here add the output to the chat, yes, no, with instructions. That's why I say why and then some instructions. Okay, so I will include all by saying a. Okay, so Aider is now offering to run the npm run build. Let's say yes. And then let's say yes. And then let's say please fix the remaining issues. Let's refresh this to make sure that that everything still works. You can complete this lesson. Oh no, there's a bug. But anyway, it's a small bug that we can never complete this last one. What if we try to run this separately? Maybe it's just a warning. It's an issue. So let me clear this up. Actually, let me reset it. And then run npm run build. Npm run build is different from npm run dev because the build one is used for production. So that means the build process will be more strict than the dev one because the dev command or script is just for development, but the build one is for production. So we need to make sure that everything is working. That's why the build process is a bit strict than the dev script. Yes, please fix. Okay, yes. You see the difference between Aider and Client. Client, when it's doing the updates, it is able to see the TypeScript errors, but Aider cannot see it because it's using search and replace or partial updates. So why don't we ask, I will get out of Aider and then let's ask Client this time. So I will invoke Client. So Client will ask me to allow it to run npm run build first. Okay. Then we will wait until the issue came out. Now it's fixing it. Now it's fixing the issue. So you see, Client is a bit more automatic with regards to fixing it this way. We're using Client for major development and use Aider for microscopic changes, but Aider might miss something, so we go back to Client in order to fix the overall issues, especially now with regards to npm run build. Okay, so I hit the rate limit for the number of tokens for the day, but it's okay since we now have completely fix the npm run build. So Client was able to do it in one go, so it's very nice. But let me go here and commit the changes so far. Oh no, so we need to add the dist folder to the git ignore. Okay, so only this is going to be committed because the dist folder contains build files, so we don't need to commit it to GitHub because the contents of the dist folder is always generated. Alright, so let's go to our browser and then let's add a new site here. Import an existing project and then let's see if I can see it here. Let's select it and then let's name this GitHub Interactive. Okay, that's good for now. This is correct and then let's deploy. Looks like the deployment is done, so we can test it. There you go. Everything is good and deployed without any issues. So with our deployment in place, we're not done yet, but for this video, this is the end of it. But we can keep improving and adding features. And that's it. We started with Bolt, built our base, and transitioned to advanced tools. We tried to use Cursor. Maybe we'll try to use Cursor more next time, but in this video, we have tried to use Client and Aider more. And I've shown you how to take a project from idea to deployment. So thanks for watching. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more tips on scaling projects with AI tools. Happy coding!